Hey there! So you're an artist, and you want to eventually make money with your art online. Well, this is what this episode is all about. How to make money online with your art. In order to make money, you need clients. And in order to get clients, you need experience and a portfolio. So what happens if you don't have that? I'm going to talk about my experience on how I became a full-time freelance artist. We're going to rewind time and talk about when I was in high school, because that's when I really set my mind to become a freelance artist. Out of high school, I didn't have anything to show for. I first started out writing just cold emails, writing brands, writing agencies, and showing them my high school portfolio, saying that I want to work with them. And that had no luck. Nobody responded, or they're like, we're not interested, you need more experience. So I got my own experience, and I did that by entering crowdsourcing sites. A lot of people have mixed feelings about crowdsourcing sites because it's kind of like a contest, and your work, all your hard work, can either win or you just did that for nothing. For all those not familiar with what crowdsourcing is, it is when a brand puts up their brief, which is what they want, and anybody can apply or create a design for it. Let's just say a brand wanted a new logo. They said they want it to be the color blue, and they want it to be this name, and they want to have a flower on it. And so me as an artist, I would create a logo with a flower, colored blue, and with their name on it, and then submit it to that crowdsourcing website. And after the deadline, the brand picks a winner to work with. And I know a lot of artists are against that because they're saying it's free work. Why don't they just hire somebody and pay them instead of trying to get 100 entries and only picking one? But for them to hire you directly and come to you without these crowdsourcing websites, you have to have that portfolio. You have to have that credibility. But on these crowdsourcing websites, on these contests, everyone has an even playing field. They're not looking at your experiences. They're not looking at clients you've worked with in the past. They're only looking at your work at that contest. And that's where I started really building my portfolio, because all these people that entered, it doesn't matter if they work with 100 brands, and it doesn't matter if I work with 0 brands. My work is right there up against theirs. And the only thing that matters is that my work at that moment is better than theirs, and that I'm gonna win that contest. Also, out of high school, my logos and my work weren't that good. I started out with really simple logos that I didn't even make in Photoshop. I made it in some type of free program that I can't even remember the name. And I would submit these works, and I would submit so many, and I would keep losing. I wouldn't even place in the finals. And I'm wondering and looking at the winners and saying, what are they doing that's making them win? And it wasn't until I really started looking at the winners and the finalists that my work started getting better. And that's when I started winning. Crowdsourcing websites aren't for everyone. I know a lot of well-established artists are not going to go to these crowdsourcing websites because they already have a base of clients and they don't have time to maybe win or lose. But as a fresh out of high school, or if you don't have a portfolio, or if you don't have a lot of clients yet, these crowdsourcing websites are actually your best friends and your best chances to land a client. Because again, it's an even playing field. Your past does not matter. Your experience doesn't matter. You're up there with everybody else. As you're winning these crowdsourcing contests, you're building client relationships. These client relationships eventually will turn into just direct business. And instead of them going through the crowdsourcing website to maybe find another good person to work with, they won't take their chances anymore because it does take a lot of work to sort through all the entries. And now they'll just come directly to you. And so that's how I built my client base. These clients are no longer going to that website, but just going directly to me for their design needs. Now that I have a client base and a solid portfolio, I am now better prepared to go to those brands, those clients that wanted a portfolio and wanted experience before, and I can now pitch myself to them. Crowdsourcing and contests are not a bad thing, and I highly recommend it to build that portfolio, to build that initial client base, especially when you're trying to become a freelance graphic designer with absolutely no experience. There's so many different crowdsourcing websites, but I'm going to tell you the two main ones I've used. I've used CrowdSpring and 99designs. I focused more on CrowdSpring because I think that was a smaller community back then. I had better chances of winning. It's so fascinating to look back at all the things that I've won and all the hard work that's been put to it, because I know that crowdsourcing and this website really started off my career in graphic design. Because without it, I wouldn't have had experience with working with real clients. Of course, there's also internships to gain experience, but I think that joining crowdsourcing websites and contests is actually a more accelerated way to gain experience. With internships, most of the time you don't even get paid. With these crowdsourcing contests, you have the possibility to get paid. And also you're gaining that one-on-one connection with these clients. And I think that's a really important skill to have. I think it's just a better experience overall if you're going to choose between internships or doing these contests to build that initial portfolio and to build that initial experience. Now that I'm an established freelance artist, I have my ongoing clients, I have my portfolio, my work has been featured in Forbes, Business Insiders, Fast Company, a lot of different publications. Do I still enter contests? And the answer is yes, I still do. And here's why. I think contests are still super important to see where you rank up and where your work is at. I want to deliver the best to my clients right now. And if my work is not the best in this contest pool, that means I have to step it up and learn new things. Also, with these contests, you have a lot of creative freedom. When you're working with a client, you're working closely with them and with their idea. But with this contest, anything is up for grabs. I'm more choosy on the contest that I pick right now, and I base them on what the price is. And it's not necessarily money now. It's mostly things that money can't buy. For example, I entered a contest and won a VIP Comic-Con experience. They flew me and my family to Comic-Con, and I've never been to Comic-Con because it's super hard to get tickets there. And also, you get VIP treatment, you know, all these long lines to meet these voice actors and artists. I can just cut through them because I was VIP and I won the contest. I also entered a contest where I won an iPad Pro with an Apple Pen and a bunch of different Snapchat swag. And also a trip to their HQ, and it was an exclusive tour, which set off a lot more possibilities. I also won a 1 ounce pure gold coin. There were only 100 of these ever minted, and they were giving one away in a contest, and the rest they were selling for thousands of dollars. And I won one of them. And that's the best way I would suggest to start off your career and make money with your art online, is by entering contests and crowdsourcing websites. You can build your client base, you can build your portfolio, and you can win some awesome experiences. And also win a lot of money. And also keep getting money because you have that client base and you have that portfolio. And I wanna mention, my sister is starting to get in these contests too, and she won $12,500 for this mask design for the Watchmen Mask Off contest. I hope you found this episode of Extra Cash helpful. If you did, don't forget to high-five that like button and leave a comment, share, and subscribe, because I'll have more videos like this. Till next time, bye!